Welcome back to another episode on the channel, guys. You know, it's your boy Ace, back at it again with another video. So before I get into the video, you know the usual, have to take the time out for the supporters, them, the one them from day one, who are like, comment, share, and everything. Don't think I forgot the haters as well. Thank you for the support as well. Always disliking, spreading your negative thoughts, and always I don't have to do in that comment section. I thank you guys for the support. So, if you're new to the channel as well, do be reminded that links in the description to the two playlists, one that consists of all the videos that have been done on the JDFs so far on the channel, and also the next one for the playlist for the JDF processing for all the videos that you will need to complete JDF processing as well. So, let's get into the video. So, basically, a lot of people have been asking me to like do more commission officers video. Yes, I'ma understand that. Because no one gets understand like when I get in the self, you know. But the thing is that I don't have much information on it because I was me just going as a regular. I didn't have the qualifications to be apply as an officer. So I kind of talk to or try to get information from someone that is actually in or is an officer while in the JDF, which is not very easy unless you probably know them as family or for some reason you know them as friend or something like that. So it's not really easy. But what I'm going to do is basically talk about what I know so far and what I've learned in training and what me see while up there as well. And that we kind of give you more insight on what officers do in regards to certain things. What I want to understand is that some people ask me and it's like, they might ask like, as an officer, do you get to go road? Well, it is, you can go road. Yes, but it's not the case where you will be like you go see officer drive around in a ratty van or nothing like that. Like a more of a casual thing, like meaning that you probably just drive your vehicle and go through a couple checkpoints or something like that. But not in the case where you will be stationed at somewhere or you go for no ops. Remember that officers are the commanders. They are the ones that issue the orders. They are the ones that uphold the organization as one. Them are the one who control most of the decisions that are made and then pass down that to the non-commissioners or so forth for them to execute or to give those instructions to the normal infantryman, like, you know, we go road and them thing. So it would be like you playing chess. When you play chess, you're not going to sacrifice your queen in the beginning. That is because, you know, them command the whole board. That is basically what a commissioned officer is. Them command the thing. And the higher you get in a rank is the more responsibility you take up. And in regards to touch on the ranking system as an officer, it is a case where, as me say, it is, as I say, it is a job. So it is a case where the opening has to be there for you to be promoted. It's not like say you just go automatically, just boom, then you just go promote yourself. You have the space after did it. You get me? Yeah, the space after did it for you get promoted too. Because it don't make no sense, you just like promote people just randomly for no reason. And because when you get promoted, you take on new responsibilities. And that are the thing. You don't just get promoted because you're gonna get promoted. You get promoted because you have shown that you are able to handle yourself when it comes down to certain situations, and it shows that you're able to make powerful decisions, which in turn will have a positive input on the organization as well as the persons that are around your circle. So automatically you set up yourself, you get promoted because you're going to take up more responsibilities as you get higher in rank. So that's why I tell people, say, it is not the case where you just go have a bag of subjects or you have some degree and you have all of that BS and then boom, you're going to get promoted through the ranks like nothing. No. That's not how it works. You have to show say, you deserve the promotion unless, I don't think them do them bandoli business there, but anyway, but you have to show say, you have earned that level to be promoted to the next level. If you not earn it, the hell, then you're not get promoted. That's why I'm telling you, say, when you have a work feed, you just feel say, oh, I have this and I have that, and automatically you're supposed to get promoted. I have man in there where I work 10 times as harder as you, 10 times harder than you. Now go work. But back to the officer thing as well. Is it officers, as I say, they're not really got road. And the fact that when you go do your course, sometimes a course like a year, sometimes more than that, 3-5 years, sometimes overseas, can be local, like Caribbean or something like that, because even other military personnel from other Caribbean countries come here as well for the courses. Also, so the thing is that sometimes you will be so used because I'm mostly bookwork. Officer thing is mostly bookwork because you know you have to strategize and have critical thinking. It's almost a book. When you come back and compete for your court, you probably not even know how sun feel like, because if I go up there, all of like let me see, all of the officers them, because them have them like them own like, office station and them thing, all of them PAC in the ever cold. When me say cold, like cold. And I remember when sub lieutenant come back, like the man say, the man got like in it go. And he said he didn't want experience, like going on the point, like we go out there, like, and you know, like oversee everything. I just go there, you know, come out there for oversee. Cause he come back and he just want to get back in it because he's been away for so long. And to be honest, he might say not even know how we manage to turn up in our sun so long. Cause as me say, you're there away for so long overseas, and in the AC, you get used to AC three to five years of that. And you get so accustomed to it that when you come back and you come back in a heat and sun, you feel like you're then in a different situation. And then let me tell you this as well. You see, officers don't really link with non-commissioned, like I mean, link with like say a private. An officer not gonna really just get up and associate themselves with you unless it's a case where it's either you're older than the man, meaning that the officer you're older than him, like a senior in that age. And you basically teach him certain things and them things they are. You didn't know him at the beginning as you know, friends and so on. But other than that, them now just get up and associate themselves with you know, normal infantry soldier and them things they like. So, because when you see them normally as an infantry soldier, you just try to avoid them. Because every minute you have either your salute, when you outside your salute, if you have on your cap, you can, when you see them, you brace, meaning that you put your hand on your side, while you're walking. You get me? Like you stand at attention, but you really stand at attention because you're a walk. Your hand just there, your side straight. So that basically brace. And that basically mean you can brace while sitting down. Unless I'm telling yourself to do that when you sit down. But if it's a case where you sit down and the officer walk past, you can't brace. You can't brace while sitting. You have to turn up and do your normal thing because you can't salute without your head cap. If you don't have a head cap, you just have to just brace. But yeah, so as me said, you hardly see them really majority at the time them in them office. I deal with important things like decision, strategy making. So people who apply for commission officers just know say it's not an easy road. You have to take up a whole heap of responsibilities. You are responsible for a lot of things, and one mistake from you can jeopardize a lot of things. Man, I lose them life. Things now go right. The whole sector might crash or something like that. So you have to just understand, say, it's a very, 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 very big responsibility where you take up on your head when you say you're going to be a commission officer. You can't weaken your mind because it's mostly mental work, but you have strong mentally and also have strong physically as well. But that has been my insight on commission officers. I hope to get more information as well in regards to the same area, because may I try get the information from other persons who probably go through the processing or in the area, but it's not so easy. But I hope you guys learned something. So don't forget to like, share, comment, and share the video with someone that you think it will be helpful to. And it's your boy Ace, and known as Hoot.